No relief for the moment for Arvind Kejriwal with the court reserving its order?
Well, you know, it is certainly no immediate relief for Arvind Kejriwal as of now, because court, after hearing both the sides, that is, you know, the CBI counsel and the Arvind Kejriwal counsel, has in fact reserved, you know, reserved the order on interim bail. In fact, remember that, you know, Arvind Kejriwal's counsel today, in fact, was seeking for an interim bail, but that relief has not been immediately granted for them. The court has reserved this order, and in fact,
it has been said that the next hearing for this is in fact scheduled on July 29th at around 3 p.m. So no immediate relief for Arvind Kejriwal as of now. He'll have to wait for the hearing on July 29th. But remember, very strong arguments came from both the CBI and Arvind Kejriwal's counsel, where in fact Arvind Kejriwal's counsel was in fact seeking an interim bail for Arvind Kejriwal, while on the other hand, CBI counsel was opposing it, and in fact they had also opposed the use of the term of insurance arrest that you know, Arvind Kejriwal's counsel was again and again emphasizing in the court today. So no immediate relief for Arvind Kejriwal. Next hearing on July 29th. Over to you.
No immediate relief. Also, if you could take us through, you know, the arguments in the court with Abhishek Manu Singhvi there, telling the court that his arrest by the CBI seemed like an afterthought, that it was, you know, by hook or by crook, it seemed the effort was to ensure that the leader remains in jail. Right, Ishika, if you can hear me.
You know, we did hear very strong arguments from both the side, you know, as you mentioned here today. In fact, Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who was in fact appearing for Arvind Kejriwal, he had challenged this arrest by the CBI. He had called it an insurance arrest. He had said that there were no merits for this arrest, there was no grounds of arrest, you know, for CBI. It was just for the sake of not letting an elected leader walk out free, is what Abhishek Manu Singhvi in fact had had said in the court. And moreover, that he had said that there are three orders that are in favor of Arvind Kejriwal, and he had cited the most recent, the Supreme Court's order of giving Arvind Kejriwal an interim bail. So after that, you know, he had questioned CBI's arrest in this particular case. Now, after that, we also heard that the court today had questioned the CBI and had said that if they already had this material, then why did they wait to arrest Arvind Kejriwal till June? So this was also, you know, the question that was posed by the court to the CBI. But we have seen how the CBI putting forth their arguments. First of all, they said that they are an investigating agency, and as the investigating agency, they have the right to decide as to when they want to charge sheet one accused and when they want to call someone for the questioning. They also said that since Arvind Kejriwal is the chief minister and the entire the policy in question was drafted under the excise minister, and that is why initially Arvind Kejriwal was not called, but later when more and more evidence came to the agency is when they called Arvind Kejriwal for the questioning. So that was, you know, the response that was given by the CBI as well in the court today. So both sides, you know, had put a very strong argument, and we did see that how in fact, you know, Abhishek Manu Singhvi appearing for Kejriwal also had given his health as a reason for the interim bail. In fact, he had said that Arvind Kejriwal's blood sugar level is dropping and it is certainly a threat, and that is was also one of the grounds for the interim bail. They had also said that there is no merit in CBI's arrest, but no immediate relief for Arvind Kejriwal, because the court has said it is going to take time, you know, to write the order, and the next date has been fixed. That is going to be 29th of July. Over to you.